Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today's topic is moving photos libraries from one location to another. Maybe it's from your computer to an external hard drive, so you need to free up space, or maybe it's from an external hard drive back to your computer to fill your computer up more. I don't know, but either way, let's talk about moving photo libraries. Let's go. All right, everyone. So first off, we need to know where our photo library lives. And there's a couple different ways to know how to do that. Number one is if we open up the photo library on your Mac, you can go to the preferences of photos. And under the preferences, you have general, and you can click on this option for library location that says show and finder. So if I click show and finder, I have this library here in my pictures folder. And that's by default, that's where photos is first generating your photo library the very first time that you open it. So in your picture folder here in your finder, it usually puts it in the pictures folder. Now you can always move it someplace else if you want to, or if you had it on an external hard drive, and we'll kind of walk through that process. So here is where my photo library lives. Now there's another method that you can do is if I click on the desktop here or applications or really anywhere within my finder, if I go in the top right and do a search, I can type in .photos library. It's gonna search this entire Mac where this library is. And if I click once on this, I can actually see the path of where this library lives. So it's in my home folder, in the pictures folder, and this is where it's at. The last option of figuring out where your photos library is at is if I actually quit out of photos, if I hold down option on the keyboard, I can click on photos, and this is actually gonna give me the option to see all of the libraries that are on my Mac. And when I have it selected here, it'll also show me the path of where this library lives. So in case you have a few others that were created by accident, this is a good way to find it. So this library here is called Photos Library New iCloud. And I actually want to change the name of this. In my previous video that talks about merging two libraries together, which I'll link down in the description below, that's why my library is called this, but I can actually change the name of the library and it won't affect anything. So I'm just going to click once on it after it's selected and just call it Main Photos Library and press return on the keyboard. And it's as easy as that to rename this library. Again, if I double click on it, it's gonna open up the same way that it was. It's linked with iCloud photos, so I can go to preferences, and it's my system library and all of that. So none of that changes. So why would you want to move a photos library? Maybe because you're running out of storage space, you wanna move it to a different Mac, various reasons, but the process is still the same on all of them. So let's pretend that I'm running out of storage space on my Mac. I wanna move it to an external hard drive. So I'm gonna plug it into my external hard drive, or I'm gonna plug my external hard drive into my Mac. And obviously, depending on how big your library is, it could be 100 gigs, 10 gigs. It's gonna take some time to copy it over. And before I move my library to my external, there is one thing I want you to take note of, and that's in the photos and the preferences is this copy items to photo library. Now, what this means is with this option checked, that means that every photo that I've imported into photos is self-contained in this nice library, which uploads to iCloud, and it's all in one nice package, this photos library. It's all self-contained. But if I uncheck this option, it's gonna say, hey, only items copied to the library will upload to iCloud photos. So that's note one, pay attention to that. So I'll click okay. But what this means is if I import any photographs into here and then I move this library, those photographs are not gonna be a part of it. And I'll show you what I mean. Back under the file menu, we have this option that says show referenced file in Finder and the consolidate option. Now, the thing that I don't like is even if you have all of the, if I go through here and select all the pictures and go up to file, it still doesn't show me the referenced files in photos, which is kind of annoying. And I know that I have some in here because if I click on this picture, for example, notice it's grayed out. But if I go to the next California picture, if I go up to file, it says show referenced file in Finder. So what that means is if I click on this, it's gonna show up where this picture actually lives within the Finder. So this is a picture that's actually in this California photo. And if I were to move this library to my external hard drive, that means that this picture may not be there. So what I want to do is go up to File and do Consolidate, and this is going to consolidate this file into the library. So now if I go back up to File, it's no longer selected. However, I have other files here that are. So it only did it for this one picture. There's a nice little trick that will allow us to find all of the photos that are referenced. And we're gonna use a smart album. So if we go over to the left-hand side under My Albums, we can click the plus sign and do Smart Album, or we can go to the File menu and choose Smart Album. And I'm gonna call this Referenced Photos, Photo Files. And we're gonna leave it at Photo, and we're gonna say Is, and we're going to change it to Referenced. Now what this is gonna do, notice it found 9 other items that matched. So I'm gonna click OK here. And so these are the other 9 photographs that have been referenced. And what I wanna do first then is go back up to File, do Consolidate. And so now it's going to copy all of these pictures so that they're in the actual library. That way when I move the library to a new location, I'm 100% confident that they are all where they need to be in this library with all the other pictures. So now we're actually going to look at what happens when you have photographs that are referenced that you did not consolidate and how they become unlinked from your photo library. So I have some photos here on my desktop, these steel wool pictures that I took with my brothers a few weeks back. So I'm going to take these photographs and import them into my photos library. By the way, really fun, steel wool photography, spin it around, light it on fire, and do a long exposure, and you kind of create these crazy different fun looking pictures. Don't worry, no one got hurt, just a coat a little singed here and there, but that's fine. I digress. Because the preferences, if I move this now, so let's actually do that. So I'm going to open up my hard drive here, and I'm going to copy the library to here. So let me close out of Photos, and I'm gonna open up a new Finder window. I can right click and do New Finder Window. I'm gonna go to my pictures, and here's my main photo library. I'm gonna drag this over to my external hard drive because maybe I wanna free up some space on my computer here. Now, another thing to note is once you do this, if you're using iCloud Photos, we're gonna have to tell it to be the system library again because it now lives on this external hard drive instead of locally on this computer. So we'll look at the options for that as well. This library is under 2 gigabytes. So for time purposes and moving them back and forth, it doesn't take long. But if you have 500 gigs or 50 gigs, it could take quite a bit longer. Now that it's copied to my external hard drive, I have it right here, and if I double click on it, it's going to open it up from the external hard drive, not my computer. Now remember, these steel wool pictures here, they're still referencing this folder on the desktop. And what's important about this is if I delete this folder here and I empty this trash can and get rid of those actual pictures, when I'm back inside of Photos and open up one of these pictures, it's gonna say, hey, missing file. And so they were referenced. I never told it to import into the photo library. So it's gonna say, hey, you need to find the original photo. And I'm gonna say, well, I have no idea where these photos at because they could have been somewhere else on the hard drive, something like that. So I'm gonna choose cancel here, and I'm gonna bring those photos back. Luckily, I made a copy on my external. I'm gonna drag this back to my desktop. And when I open these photos back up, they're going to relink to those pictures. Now, what you would want to do is you go and select these pictures and you go up to the file and you choose consolidate. And what consolidate is going to do is it's going to take all of those referenced photographs and copy them into the library. That way they're all self-contained. They can be part of iCloud Photos and they're nice and neat in the same location as all of these other photographs. Now that that is done, I can freely delete this folder and trash it, and all of these pictures here that were referenced are now inside of the library with all of the other ones. So I want to make sure that I then go back to Photos, choose Preferences, and make sure that you have copy items to Photos library. That way when you're importing new stuff, you just don't have to worry about it. Now, this photo library, as I said, is back on my external hard drive. And all of this is here. So what I would want to do is go to Photos, choose Preferences, and tell it to use it as system library. And notice it's going to say, hey, switching the system library is going to turn off iCloud Photos, and that's perfectly fine. It's going to turn off the other Photos library that I had, and it's going to merge it with what's in iCloud.com. So I'm going to choose OK, and then I'm going to turn on iCloud Photos. I like to make sure I download the originals to the Mac if you have the storage space. And it's gonna go through and make this the new library. So number one, before you do that, I always recommend make sure you have a physical copy. If it's all in iCloud, download the originals first by doing the download originals to Mac before you merge or switch to any other library. And now if I go out to iCloud.com, we'll sign in with the same Apple ID that I'm using. I'll go to Photos. And we're gonna wait for those additional photos to upload because pretty much we added 6 more photographs. So those 6 photographs should bump up to iCloud.com, and now they're essentially merged together. Now that my library is moved to my external hard drive, I could go back to the picture folder locally on this computer here, and I can drag this to the trash once I know all of this is said and done and completed. Now again, if you're not using iCloud Photos at all, then it's just a matter of moving the library from one location to another. And if you have multiple photo libraries, you can only use one that synchronizes with iCloud Photos. So if you're not using iCloud Photos at all, don't even worry about this option here. Don't even worry about the system library, because really it doesn't matter, because you're not involving it in the ecosystem to synchronize to the cloud and in return go to your iPhone or iPad or other devices. You don't have to worry about any of that. You're just purely moving the library from one location, copying it, and going to another location. And if you have an iPhone that you're using with iCloud, it's going to update there and all of the other devices. Once all of that is done, then I would say empty the trash and move that library off of this computer, because now it's safe and sound on external hard drive. But also, don't just depend on the external hard drive. I would have another backup if you're able to, or if you have enough storage on this device, you know, make sure that you are downloading the original photographs so that they're all there, just in case something happens funky with the cloud. All right, so now if we jump back to iCloud.com, let's refresh, see if those photos are uploaded, and here are those 6 photos. They're up in iCloud, and this library that now lives on this external hard drive will continue to sync with all of your other devices. So if I minimize this, now that I feel confident that everything is in the cloud, I can go back to the trash, and now I can actually empty this and get rid of that library, empty it, because now it fully resides on the external hard drive here. And if I open that up, I'm back to where I left. So that is how to move one library to another location. Aside from just manually dragging it, you can also use a third-party application to move libraries. It's up to you. It's a little bit extra money. It does some additional things for finding duplicates, but it's still an option. There's a popular one called Power Photos by Fat Cat, I believe. Yeah, so Fat Cat Software, Power Photos. It's a third-party application designed to manage your photo libraries, merge libraries, find duplicates, all sorts of stuff. So check that out. Download a free version. I personally don't use it, but I know some people that personally do, and reading some of the reviews and what's out there on the internet, it seems like it's a pretty popular with a good amount of success using it. So this could be an option for you also to manage and move your library. So I'm not going to go too much in depth with it, purely because I don't use it that much for moving libraries, because I just drag it, but that's also an option for you as well. Oh, one helpful trick here. Sometimes if you have an older library, you may have issues where it may not open or it's not loading properly. So you can actually repair a photos library. And so if you quit out of all the photo libraries and hold down Option and Command on the keyboard and then click on Photos, it's going to bring up an option to say, hey, you are about to repair this library. And you can click on Repair, and it will go through type in my password to verify, it'll go through and repair that library if it's ever having issues. So if you ever get stuck and it's trying to, it's not loading or it's not opening properly, try repairing the library and you might just have some success with that to restore that library and get it back up and running for you. So that's pretty much it for moving your photos libraries from one location to another. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you did, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, share the video with mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, whomever, and we'll see you next time.